Today's adventure begins here in downtown Celebration. As a recording of this, it is Sunday, March 26th, 2023. Sometimes I will occasionally go to the every week Sunday farmer market, farmer art market. But I'm going to branch out over to Lakeland on this Sunday for an event I've never been to. An event that takes place, I believe, once a year, and I think they might do a pop-up throughout the year, so once or twice a year, called the Punk Rock Flea Market. Now, they do punk rock flea markets in different areas of the country as well, but they also do one here in Florida, about an hour from here, in Lakeland. A buddy of mine's gonna pick me up, and we're gonna cruise over there in a bit, but first, coffee. Located on the corner of Bloom and Front Street. Also, whenever they do events down here, they always block the streets off. Streets closed in that direction. And also, whenever they do events down here, there's usually a pretty long line at the coffee stand. But a little more than normal, anyway. Golf cart coming through. Pike Place regular coffee with a little cream and sugar. Acquired. Right here upon Lake Reinhardt. It was pretty busy in there, but because I wasn't getting a latte or food or anything like that, it's pretty much in and out, even though there's a lot of people waiting for their custom orders. I just went with like a basic coffee. Welcome everyone. Out of the woo here. Do not take that last step over the side. It's a doozy. I guess from Groundhog Day. Could be a little misleading. The weather is very nice right now. However, it's kind of early. I would imagine that the temperature will rise just a little bit. Whoa, that is extra piping hot. Good thing I have the jacket. Of course, I was holding it like this. And it kind of gets a little too warm and then you put your fingers around the, not dust jacket, but the heat jacket, the heat wrapping. I'm inviting you to join me today. Shall you? Right about now it's 74 degrees. It's gonna get up into the 80s, it looks like. And the commute over to Lakeland, currently 73 degrees. And it's also gonna get up to 84 by noon over there. So yeah, it's gonna be a warm one. I believe a lot of the events inside though. Well, hopefully. Here is the flyer. Flea Market Lakeland is a place called Swan Brewing, March 26th, which is today, is a recording of this. But they're gonna have vendors and even some bands. Let me see exactly how far it is from point A to point B from here. According to the Maps app on my phone, 43 minutes, 37 miles, 43 minutes, of course, on I-4 westbound. You never know, okay, there's a different route. You can go an hour and 14 minutes. I-4 westbound giveth and I-4 westbound taketh away. Let's see what happens. But do not want to take away from the fact that there is a fully kicking and kicking and popular transpiring event taking place down here at this moment too. This happens each and every Sunday. I think from 10 to 1 or 10 to 2, depending on the weather. What I'm going to only happens like once, maybe twice a year. Now, one thing, the fountain down here off of Market Street in downtown Celebration does not have is a marking that says Lakeland where I'm heading, but it does have some markings for other areas, like St. Pete, 104 miles as the crow flies, even Burbank, on my kind of still close to my old stomping grounds in Southern California, you know, close to Hollywood, close to Anaheim, Orange. I would love this fountain though. It's like a little splash pad. Sometimes people come in here and run around through it. They get their bathing suits on and cool down, sometimes even without bathing suits on. I mean, they have their clothes on, but they're wearing regular clothes. I mean, who knows what happens after hours, but you know, I want to talk about that. I'm gonna go over to the bank and to the ATM and get some cash out, because I figure some of the vendors over in Lakeland would probably be easier instead of paying with a card, and I want to get a few things, have some cash. Yeah. This is one crazy gourd. Oh, that's the name of the booth. Crazy Gourds.
Oh, no, they don't.
And I think fitting. A lot of delicious fruits and vegetables through here. Look at these pineapples. Basically, the entire area down here is just blocked off for vendor booths under canopies of tents down Market Street. One place I have purchased items from in the past is getting fresh guacamole made down here. Highly recommend it. You know, it's definitely not too incredibly warm yet. As stated, it's probably gonna warm up a little bit, but right now it is pretty nice to be walking around Market Street, doing some shopping for everyone. I'm not gonna buy anything here. I'm heading to the ATM, get some cash for Lakeland. It's very convenient. There is one right over by the clock over there. There's a bank on the corner here with an ATM. Cash acquired. Got it in my wallet inside my fanny pack there. Fannying it up. Hello, squirrel. Getting a little snack there, huh? It's a stare down, squirrel. You lost. All right, I am now in the world of Micah Mobile, passing the Mickey Power Pole. All right, arrived at the first destination, the hair shanty. Well, not really the hair shanty. It's a place called Fred's over here on the corner. It's a buffet place that I've never been to here in Lakeland. Now, before getting our punk rock on, we're going to go to Fred's Market Restaurant. Mike and Abby are here as well.
Get our good eating on.
Gonna get. So you've been here before, right?
Oh yeah. Fried chicken, salad bar, vegetables.
All right. 15-20 minutes.
All right. So there is a 15-minute wait. We've got some of the local people here. So I think that's I think that might be the guy that started Publix over here. Publix started in Lakeland. And while waiting, looking at this piggy bank. It's a piggy bank, but it's really a pig. They have merchandise over here. They have tumblers. They have hats. Things like that. They even has their own coffee brand here. At Fred's. Hello, piggy bank pig. We're waiting over here in this little area here. It says in 1954, Elton and Evelyn Johnson started a family dining, and also they pumped gas and stacked sandwiches. How many times have you been here, Micah?
Four, maybe five times.
This is like a regular.
Yeah, we're in Lakeland, we usually come here.
You can get either the buffet or you can just buy a one plate, right? Yeah. So we'll do the one plate. I might do the one plate. This is a very interesting setup. I've never seen. So you got the full buffet. It's called the full market table. You can get everything as much as you want over and over and over and over and over. Or you get the blue plate, which is everything that's on the buffet, but just one plate. Or you could do a one trip, which has three courses, one salad plate, and a dessert. The blue plate does not have dessert. You can add that on for $1.49. Or you can have unlimited to the salad table for $13.09. Or you can have unlimited to just the veggie table for $15.22. I'm gonna go with the blue plate. Okay, problem solved. I asked one of the employees for a blue plate and they have given me one blue plate, which I am gonna load up to my heart's content. It's better than just kind of doing the full buffet where I just go back over and over and over. I'm just going to go with one blue plate, fill this thing up to the brim. Probably the most confusing menu I've probably ever seen. Everything like fluctuates. This is like $15 for the blue plate. And then Micah ended up getting the non-blue plate. So does that mean he can go back and get more and more?
No, it just means he gets a salad bar and a dessert too.
Okay. Well, that's all it is. So one plate. So you just guys got the one plate, yep. But then also a salad bar and a dessert.
Yes.
For like a few bucks more.
Yep.
So you got the salad bar. I don't get the salad bar because I went with the blue plate. All right, that was pretty dang good. Good Southern food, very, very busy. Also, this is interesting. These parking spaces here are obscuring and blocking off the signage to where was a drive-through bank that you can't even get to anymore. You can go in from this way, but this teller isn't, this telling bank ATM area isn't even open anymore. It's kind of weird. Just like a little subsidiary overhang from a bank that's not open next to Fred's. Very peculiar. Drive-through bank not open and can't even go over there. There's even a tow-away zone sign right there. And you can't even get out that way. Have drove a couple miles over to the Swan Brewing area. See, there's a Swan up there. And basically everyone's just kind of parked wherever they can find parking. If you look across the lake, past the bike lane sign and all that, you can see all the booths over there too as well for the Lakeland Punk Rock Flea Market. Looks as if they have blocked off an entire section of the street next to the lakefront. And there's one of those little windy balloony guys, balloony face guys over there waving in the breeze. There goes some sod.
Sod's punk rock, dude.
Punk rock sod! Sod. Punk rock sod! stick it up your bum, you sod!
Sod!
I would say of any day of the week where there are more road closures, I think Sundays are probably the most road closures. Oh, classic vehicle alert here. Road closures on a Sunday. you know, good celebration had their market. Roads were closed. This is also, roads are closed. All right, I am officially inside the vendor area, and there are a lot of booths in here. Quite a few booths, more than I thought there were. I think they said there was gonna be like 70 booths this year when I was reading all the information online of all the different booths that are scattered around here in Lakeland for this event. Oh, I like this, the WTF club, the Welcome to Florida club right here. Oh, the Never Say Die club too.
Cool little camera you got there.
Thanks, bro. Yeah. These are just stickers, right? Not magnets.
Yeah, well, one of them's a magnet. I sold out.
Oh, you found
most of them, but
okay.
Yeah, I sold out of the magnets really quick.
A couple years ago, I think you were at another convention. I think all you had were the stickers.
Yeah, and then I did get the magnets, but they were hot. I sold quick.
And this artist's name is Chris Sellender. Is a brain riding a skateboard, and a bunch of retro T-shirts over here that you can get as well. Like this one, like this long sleeve avail. Yeah, the Kennedys over here. Quite a sort. We got a little skateboard area set up. A band's about to start to perform. There's an assortment of everything out here. A pretty dang good turnout as well. Oh yeah, Micah got the old school Cheshire Cat vinyl silently judging your plastic bag. Oh, that makes sense. The skate area set up by the skate park of Tampa. Right, this booth right here has a lot of really good stuff. There's Spaceship Earth down here. Look at all these old guide maps. $5 to Splendid China. A couple Universal Studios Hollywoods. Look at this. I've got the Spring Break, Disney Break, Walt Disney World, the Roger Rabbit on here. Oh my gosh, Pleasure Island. I might need to, I think I'm gonna purchase a few of these. I'm definitely gonna get these, but I might get a few other ones. Check out some of the old Mickey D's. I just spent my first $35. I'll give a little haul afterwards, but this booth's got some really good stuff. Be Bright Vintage. I'm gonna spend too much money. Just love all this retro Disney stuff.
I figured I had to get this.
Trolls. There's E.T. right there. What is this Goofy right here? You know, my mom used to have one of these. She put her little little scrub pad in right here. These frogs. This is pretty cool too. That's very vintage. Only $8 for that. Yeah, $8. It's pretty good.
That's it.
All right, gonna continue on. Keep going booth to booth. Street by street, booth by booth. Taking it all in, taking it all back. I'm just paraphrasing those pretty cool shirts over here at DOA. There's a Rocketeer smelly thing that you hang from your rearview mirror. What do they call that thing? I'm drawing a blank on that. A air freshener. And they got some Ed Wood shirts. Here's like a Tiki Bride Rocketeer shirt. Ghoulish Mortal as well. And of course, Ghostface over there in the distance. Reading Roman numerals, I guess that would be, this is the fifth edition of that. This looks like a spoof on Green Day's Dookie. Henry Rollins down there, Danzig over here. And here's a close-up of one of those little windy balloony guys right there waving in the breeze. And plenty of food trucks, which I'm pretty full at the moment, so I won't be getting any food. Printed event t-shirts. It's always kind of neat when they do this. They make them right here, screen printing right here on site. It is really rocking up there. Everyone enjoying the live music out here in Lakeland. Again, I am really content with the turnout out here. This place is a beehive of activity. A lot of punk rock shirts. All right, this is a pretty awesome booth. It's called Toxic Roots, but check out the tiki vibes here. I think out of all of them, I really like this one here. This is pretty cool. And they also have skateboards, they have ashtrays, and they have stickers. I went ahead and bought a t-shirt and threw it in the bag. I'll do the haul at the end, like I said. Oh, you got the checkerboard slip-ons up here. The Scully right here, it says Scully's. It's a skull. And yes, there is an actual brewery here that this event is taking place. Oh, look at this, this is the volume 4. Edition over there. That was last year's flyer. And of course I showed this earlier. I found a photo online, but this is the larger version of this year's as well. And of course the date down there. as well as like a skull with a mohawk there and horns inside the Swan Brewery establishment. And it just seems as the day progresses, just more and more people keep showing up out here. Really quite a really good turnout for an event like this. I am pleasantly, I've said this before, but I was not expecting there to be this many people showing up for this out here. This is awesome. I ended up getting a can of water as well. Check out this Misfits gnome over here. Over here, some Pop Figures, and there is a Jawbreaker Dear You skateboard. I think for me, probably Jawbreaker's best album. Dear You, my favorite album.
No, this is the microphone I bring, so thank you. He's dead. He's worried.
All right. We've got a special guest singer from Deep Pusher Come Home. We're going to have kind of a special last minute song.
It's also kind of nice to hang out this to get out of the sun. It's hot out here. There are quite a few people in line to get the t-shirt screen printed over here as well. There's some sort of bouncy ball thing over here as well. And Kick Right there, button and vintage and pen folk right here. They made my pins for the giveaway I did a long time ago. Check out this hot dog. Should get a hot dog. That is a shirt I would definitely wear. All in all, a very successful and fun day. Central Florida, Lakeland, Punk Rock Flea Market. 2000. Definitely a good time. It looks like it's going to be successful for many years to come. Check out this Sick of It All logo there on that t-shirt. There's people skating. This guy's skating out here. Got a ramp slide over here. This booth has a lot of t-shirts with cats on it. Felinius. I like kitties and beer. Almost looks like Hobbes, Calvin and Hobbes. Also a very beautiful day for this. Some clouds in the sky, a little overcast, a little sunny, but no rain as of right now. Oh yeah, over here at Dark Cycle. Take a look at this. This shirt has my name written all over it. Well, Big the Foot's name written all over it. And sadly, they did not have that shirt in my size. This other place over here, it's two people outside, Goods from the Grave. They have a pretty good assortment of very unique items inside, including Furbies. They do like their own little kind of horrific twist on the old Furbies back from like the early 2000s and all that into the Furbies. So I kind of browse around in this, and there's some pretty unique and creative stuff you see at a lot of these different places. All right, I just purchased the, I got another bag too. I got to purchase like one of the coolest shirts. I'll show it to you. All right, I think we're gonna start heading out and leave the Lakeland area, at least this little flea market area, that is. Good time. This is the corner of Pine and Lake Wire Drive where all this took place. Is it always in this area?
Yeah.
So it's always been in this spot?
In this spot and in Lakeland.
In Lakeland.
Now, if it's not like Fort Lauderdale, they have a completely different location for it, but I believe it's the same.
Didn't last year they do it in Tampa or St. Pete?
I think it was St. Pete. They did one over in St. Pete. You're right.
But normally it's here in Lakeland, but is it always in this spot in Lakeland?
This spot, yes.
This is always the spot.
As far as I know, this spot right here. Next to Swan. The Swan.
Yeah.
They put it on.
I like the back of this guy with the mohawk stack. It says, hug a punk.
Yeah.
Or punk, I'll hug you and I'm a punk or something like that.
Free hugs from
free,
a punk.
Free hugs. Free hugs from a punk. I like that.
Yeah.
He's got the mohawk and the studded jacket.
There's like, it's like a, remember that photo? There's like a historical photo of this dude, big mohawk and everything, and he's handing a little boy a flower.
Yeah.
And it's like showing that.
I've seen a lot of those images on screen printing and stuff now too. They've used that.
It's cool.
All right, we're gonna head out of here. Also in this general vicinity in Lakeland, was actually something else going on that coincides wearing an appropriate hat. I said I wasn't going to too many spring training games. I went to the Rays versus the Yankees at Disney. But the Rays are here in Lakeland over at, I think it's Coach Joe Merchant Stadium. And the game's almost over. Didn't really want to go to the full game. But since we're in the neighborhood, I've convinced them to drive by the stadium real quick and just kind of get a little peek-see. All right, just dropped off for 1 second. Just kind of walk up to the front here. Obviously, I'm not going to be filming the game or anything like that because the game is almost over. But I just wanted to walk up to the Joe Merchant Stadium. Oh, there's a pretty good crowd of people up there on the berm over there. Looks like it is sixth inning. Rays are down 5-6 over the Tigers. And out front are here two sculptures, two notable men from this area. Looks like someone has left some business there, a little bird. He's got his little cap on here. This is George Jenkins and Joker Marchant. George Jenkins started Publix, the founder of Publix Supermarkets, while Joker Marchant was the director of Parks and Recreation for 30 years in this area. They're shaking hands and having a meeting of the minds, I guess, like a passing of the baton, if you will. Mystery machine. And now back over in Celebration, where they are, it's about 3:30, 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Looks like they're still breaking down some of the farmer's market that was down here from earlier. Haven't taken down the stanchions over there to let any other cars up in here. Oh yeah, I gotta show the few items that I got before I end this video. All right, I got this very sweaty devil shirt. Take a look at the back of this. How does this sums up Florida in every possible way. That's a quintessential description of what Central Florida is like. So I got this toxic root surfer, which is the creature, the Black Lagoon here. Also toxic roots. I got this Frankie drinking a tiki mug. I got the colorful version of the Florida, Have a Toxic Day. I got Roger Rabbit on the Disney Break 89. They had one that was 1990 with Roger on it, but I went with the 89 because that was the opening year of MGM Studios. Also got with this little Splash Mountain item here, Pleasure Island. This is Walt Disney World's 21st birthday. I also got this Splendid China guide map, which is pretty dang awesome. You don't see too many Splendid China guide maps, so I went ahead and got this as well. Well, I guess it's not really a guide map, it's just an advertisement for Splendid China. And then Universal Studios Hollywood, which I'm very partial to. I love Universal Studios Hollywood. Showing the back lot, top screen, the stunt show, all that. That is like a thing of beauty right there. And then of course this one, the Ride the Movies campaign, Earthquake on there. Well, maybe not the Ride the Movies campaign, but at least the Earthquake when it is being utilized as like the promotional material. Oh, there's Norman up top and Jaws. Take a look at this. Lights, camera, action. So good. So I'll look through those a little bit later. But I like to have this. They don't take up a lot of room either. So I just like to have little knickknacks of thing that I get. And a pretty good haul from the Punk Rock Flea Market in Lakeland. And that's going to do it for today. Ending in downtown Celebration. But I went to a variety of different places. Got some merchandise. Went by a Ray Spring train. Did not go in. Went through downtown Lakeland to an event, and also saw an event here that started earlier that happens every Sunday. A little summertime events. Well, not summertime, springtime. What am I saying? Springtime. It feels like summertime. That's how hot it is. Early spring. Spring just started a few days ago. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Never go to me for the seasons. The vlog is over.